श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्ण। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देव महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। आर डूइंग द ट्रेडिशनल वे ऑफ उपासना, व्हेन दे डू एनी मंत्र चैंटिंग, बिफोर दैट दे हैव अंग न्यास एंड हृदय न्यास। द रूल इज देवो भूत्वा देवम यजेत। वी वॉन्ट टू वर्शिप द गॉड, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू इन्वोक एन प्रिंसिपल इन अवर सेल्स, एंड देयर फोर द होल बॉडी इज इन्वोक विद वेरियस प्रिंसिपल्स। सी, फॉर एवरीथिंग इज एग्जिस्टिंग एट थ्री लेवल्स, वन इज नेचुरल, सेकेंड इज फंक्शनल, थर्ड इज कंट्रोल्ड। लाइक आईज, इफ यू टेक the eyes that we see of each other, they are structures. In and through the structural eyes, there is a final vision. Eyes may be beautiful, if vision is not there, it is useless. So structural, functional. And this function of vision or any organ is possible when it is blessed by the devata. See? So the presiding deity, the eyes, is the sun. I told you to switch off, but mine is on. See, a typical thing. Teaches everybody but himself dumb. So this presiding deity for the eyes is the Surya Devata, the sun. The presiding deity for the nose is the Ashwini Kumar. The presiding deity for the legs is Vishnu. The presiding deity for the hands is Indra. In this manner, every function is presided over by the presiding deity. And this is how all divine potentialities are called as devata. Deva means dyotana deva, which introduces an element of age or illumination. So these devata are the one which are invoked through the mantra sadhana. See, when we are chanting the mantra like Om Namah Shivaya, but it should be chanted like that, Om Shivaya, not Namasha, 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 not like that. As holding Shiva, kyun khada hai Shiva? See, so this mantra chanting is meant for invocation of that devata which is presiding that mantra. See, suppose you take Ram Raksha Stotra, Asya Ram Raksha Stotra Mantra, and then what is the Chanda, who is the Devata, who is the Rishi, and the Kilakam, everything is detailed there. In short, all the mantras are meant for invocation of the Devata, the divinity contained in that mantra. That is the purpose. See. Therefore, those who know, they will see it. The Bija Mantra is added before the mantra. Like Om Gam Ganapate Namaha, Om Klim Krishnaya Namaha, Om Rim. Like that, these are the mantras and they are indicating the deity. The word mantra means mantra. These two things put together becomes mantra. Means mananat mantra. When you reflect upon, when you do mananam, Then tra trayate, that which protects the devotee from the relative existence and brings him back to his essential nature, that formula is called as mantra. Like, you know, in a school, the teacher asked the chemistry class. One student was absolutely ignorant what is going on. He was with himself. So the teacher said, you tell, what is the formula of water? You are not paying attention. No, ma'am, I am paying attention. You ask me, what is the formula of water? HIJKLMNO. He said, what is this funny? You only told H2O. He said, HIJKLMNO formula. So these devatas are meant to be invoked through this formula. That formula is called as the mantra. See. So when you do mananam, mananam is what? First mechanical chanting. Thereafter, that is done by the mind. Same mantra is used for chanting to work on the mind. Third stage is we experience the meaning of that mantra. These are the three stages. Therefore, chittam mantra. And where this is happening? It is all happening in the mind or the chitta. Bhagavacharya says, chittam chitcha vijaniya takara rahitam takaro vishaya dhyasaha japa ragau yatha manau. Chit and chit are the same. And consciousness are the same. When consciousness, objectivity is mind. Mind plus objectivity is consciousness. And objectivity is the sense of otherness. So that knowledge where the sense of otherness valid, that knowledge is called as mind. And that knowledge where sense of otherness disappears, that knowledge is called as consciousness. This mantra sadhana is practiced for dissolving the mind, meaning removing the objectivity knowledge and dissolving in the objectless awareness. That is the purpose of this mantra sadhana. Therefore, mantra, this is what we have seen in our first of this second chapter of Shiva Sutra. Now for that, the next sutra tells, asya cha of this prayatnaha sadhakaha. See, how we attain fulfillment through mantra sadhana. One says in Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter, yajnyanam japa yajnosmi. Jump that of the mantra. See. So this mantra sadhana is one of the most potent spiritual practice if it is practiced properly. See. So for that, na sadhakaha, one has to put intense effort without becoming serious about anything. Mantra sadhana is done two ways. One way is sakama sadhana, wherein we do something for getting something. See? And in that sakam sadhana, there will be one rules. You should not eat this, you should not eat this, you should sleep like that, you should stand like, you should be inside the water, so many things. But when the mantra sadhana is done, only for the purification of the mind. See, Vedanta Shastra tells, karmani chitta shuddhyartham aikagryartham upasanam. So mantra sadhana is both karma as well as upasana. It is karma because we are chanting by the speech. Speech is a karmendriya. To chant Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, ओम श्री राम जय राम। दिस इज कर्म एंड द सेम मंत्र इज डन एज उपासना। सो व्हेन आर चैंटिंग द वर्ड श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम, राम फर्स्ट इज अपियरिंग इन अवर हार्ट एज ब्लिस हैप्पीनेस फर्स्ट, एंड व्हेन इट इज मैच्योर्ड इनफ देन जपा नेचुरली लीड्स टू साइलेंस। लाइक व्हेन द फ्रूट मैच्योर्स राइपन्स ऑन द ट्री इटरली सेपरेटेड, वी डोंट हैव टू स्ट्रगल टू प्लक इट, इट ऑटोमेटिकली इज। इन द सेम मैनर व्हेन दिस मंत्र इन अवर वैखरी वाणी मैच्योर इनफ एंड वाणी इज प्यूरिफाइड बिकॉज चैंटिंग देन दिस ड्रॉप्स फ्रॉम द वैखरी वाणी एंड एंटर्स द मध्यमा वाणी। एंड व्हेन द मंत्र एंटर्स द मध्यमा वाणी वर्ल्डलीज आर ऑफ hardly any consequences to such a master, to such a seeker. He is living in this world, but he doesn't belong to this world. Now he has discovered the real bliss, joy in the Lord's name. See friends, Lord's name is chanted like we eat chocolate, not like we eat the what do you call Ayurvedic medicine? How we did Ayurvedic medicine? The worst, I have suffered a lot. And then I discovered the secret of Ayurveda. You tell them, they say, don't tell me, we know. And they will take your pulse. And also, in rich institution, they take the purse also. Depending upon, they will say, do panchakarma. It is not necessary for body to do panchakarma, but it's a very good money spinning business. So they will tell you. See? And after that panchakarma for 15 days, they will dry you as if you are thrown in a washing machine and came out. And then they'll say, now you should not do it for last 1 month, next 1 month. The whole life is only doing panchakarma, remove and put. And they give this is called as, once I was given Kutajarishta. The name is also terrible. Kutajarishta. And you take only once. It is so bitter. Next time to avoid to take the second dose, you tell the doctor, I am okay. Perfectly all right. It is better to with the medicine, with the disease, than to suffer with the medicine. Chanting Lord's name is like Ayurvedic medicine, you know. Anusha, 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 Anusha. If you are a Gujarati, JSK, JSK, JSK. Even text messaging to God. He doesn't have phone number. They don't understand this. See? We have to chant the Lord's name as we chant or as we eat the chocolate. We don't take the chocolate and take a glass of water. No. Put the chocolate in the mouth, immediately it goes to the parking lot. And slowly keep on tasting it. In the same manner, taste the Lord's name. Om Sri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram. where from Om's A begins and where Ram's Ma dissolves, that is the experience of this mantra. Like, you know, your ECG, the needle goes up from a point and something and comes down. But the base rate, in the same manner, the mantra begins, flutters some time, goes back. Again, flutter time goes back. And in between these two mantra chanting, the Tatra Niramisham, there the mind is objectless awareness. And ultimately, this mantra, prayatna, properly done, sadhakaha, it is fulfilling. And a person who is properly doing this mantra sadhana, one of the most important things you can see, that person is always at peace. Because he has tasted the bliss of freedom from thoughts, feeling thoughtlessness, freedom from thoughts, presence and absence of thoughts becomes equal. When we do something, we gain, we lose. When we gain something, lose something, we are happy or unhappy. He who is at peace with himself, he goes through experiences of up and down, but his peace is never. That is what is called as prashanti. Ashanti we know. Opposite of ashanti is shanti, and that which is ashanti and shanti is prashanti. That is what is called as prashanti nilayam. See. So prashanti nilayam is that there is a lot of chaos all around, yet you are at peace. See, friends, this is the real meaning of mantana. Prayatna sadhakaha. And by proper practice, it becomes instantaneously. It doesn't take any time. Doesn't take any time. No, please. Later. Because if we put efforts are always created with somebody. Now just play experiment. Wherever you are, now play. Husband or wife. And see what thoughts are coming. Because husband or wife is a person. Person will always have thoughts. Then play as parents or children. So when you play parents, the thoughts pertaining to children come. When you play children, the thoughts pertaining to parents will come. Somebody is a personality. Where there is a personality, there are efforts. And now, remain as nobody. No thoughts. See? This is what prayatna sadhakaha. Amishabdha khasya sampashyan shakuner priye Kshipram akarshu yad vege na jenatu. When the bird in the sky is some kind of food for itself, maybe fish or meat or something, how fast it comes down, attracted towards it. In the same manner, the bird is effortlessly attracted and dives deep into its own source. See, therefore, prayatna sadhakaha, we have to put efforts, ultimately reach effortlessness. See, when we are learning driving a car, how much tense we are. We hold on to the steering so hard, and when we have to get down, we forget that we have to leave the steering inside. You pull it and come out, it has come out. Tense. But once we become in that, then there is a phone over here, and then you are driving and you are talking to a wife also, and yet you are able to manage because now effortless. See, friends. As we effort, comment on the world, in the same manner, we are able to get effortlessness. So, Patanjali says, the practice is prayatna shaithilya ananta samapatti bhyam. Shaithilya, effortlessness. It is possible, samapatti bhyam, when you merge in the infinite. Where is finite? Efforts. When no finite, no efforts. See? Prayatna sadhakaha. Attainment of this effortlessness is the ultimate merging in the absolute. Now, how this is done? How this is achieved? Now, this is the next that comes. So, in the third sutra, the teacher says, Vidya sharira satta mantra rahasyam. Rahasyam means the secret. See? So, mantra rahasya. What is the secret of this mantra? Whichever mantra you take. See? So, it is said, Vidya sharira satta. Is very technical and extremely subtle. Be very attentive. Satta, support. Vidya, knowledge. Sharira, house. Three things. Now, when we want to refer to anything in this world, the reference is made with the words. The world is defined as asti bhati priya rupa iti pancha amshakam adyatrayam brahma rupam jagat rupam tato dvaya. Satchidananda is the Brahman, nama rupa is the jagat. When a child is born, rup, form is born. Immediately we have to give. And his name and form, they are always together. So, he is with the Lord and the name is with us. And they are together. When we say water, immediately the form of us to us. When we say laddu, the object laddu comes. In the same manner. When we chant the mantra, the word, the meaning of the mantra must appear in front of us. Then only the mantra sadhana is complete. See, friends. Why this happens? Because our words do not carry meaning. The reason being, we are at the periphery of our personality. See. So here, the mantra, vidya shatta, mantra rahasyam. So, objects are indicated by the words. So, the word is the sharira, the body, that object is existing. See? When I say laddu, rasagulla, where is that laddu, rasagulla? In our mind. That which is not included in our mind does not exist for us. Very simple. When I did some operation for my big toe in what happened many years before. Something was growing and my friend was there. He said, Swamiji, we should remove it right away. What is this growing? I said, this is, oh, the fool say, I have got a wisdom tooth, I have got a wisdom toe. No, don't make joke, it is not good, you have to remove it. I said, okay, remove it with him. And then he gave the local anesthesia there. For 10 minutes he said, do you feel? I said, what? That means I was not feeling anything there. He said, now you can watch, no problem. And then he put the lapel into that and removed it like you remove the ice cream and scoop like that. Removed, and I saw that everything, but no pain because the toe was a chemical meditation. See? That which is not included in the mind does not exist for us. So what is the support of the total world, our mind. See, friend. And in this mind, the name exists. See. So, the object, rasagulla, rupa, form. And the word rasagulla in our. So, when the word rasagulla comes in the mind, oh, many years I have not taken rasagulla, slowly, happiness starts happening. Then you are told, oh, tonight we are going to have rasagulla. Really, happiness increases. And ultimately, that pathetic thing called as rasagulla lands your tongue, you close your mouth, eyes, and brahmanandam paradam, because the object and the expenser, they merge into one. Ananda is only when the experiencer and the experienced division dissolve into the homogeneous one, that experience is called as bliss or ananda. In other words, that experience where there is division of experiencer and the experienced, that is realization. See, friends, our presence is not recognized by us through any means. Our presence is not recognized by us objectively. Our presence doesn't require any certification unless you have to take the pension. Don't require. Our presence is pramana niranubhuti. That experience which doesn't demand any authority to. Because I cannot become an object of knowledge. That is the mantra rahasya. See? So, vidya sharira satta. Satta is the support. Sharira is the word, vidya is the knowledge. See. Now what is that vidya sharira satta? Here the teacher tells, sarve varnatmaka mantra te shaktyatmaka shaktistu matruka jneya sacha jneya shivatmika. Now here is a very subject and very deep. Sarve varna maka mantraha, all the mantras are made out of letters. Om Namaha Shivaya. Each word is made out of letters. See, like Rama, Rakar plus Akar, Ra, Makar plus Akar, Ma, Rama. They are called as Varna. And Varnas are also called as Akshara. Akshara means they don't get influenced by anything. Whether you write Ra by using the Ra, or you like write Ravana by using the Ra doesn't become holy, doesn't become unholy. When you wipe away whatever you have written, Rama you have written, you erase. When you erase the Rama letter word, nothing happens to Ra. Ra remains. This Ra. Ra is not on the paper, it is in the mind. See. Therefore, Sarve Varanatmaka, all the mantras are Varanatmaka. And Shaktyat mantraste Shaktyatmaka Priye. And these mantras are meant invocation of the inherent potentiality behind that mantra represented by the presiding deity, Devata. See. And when that Devata invoked through the mantra sadhana, then in that devotee or in that upas, all those potentialities start becoming manifest and they are called these. See, this mantra sadhana is the one which brings us back to our own self. See, once mind doesn't want to die, like nobody wants to die. So what the mind does, keeps on eating food. The food mind is either the past memories or the worries. When the mind comes in utter pretty, the mind dissolves. Therefore, many people are afraid of lens. So they will be putting the birds in their ears. Or they want to hear something. One day, someone came to meet me somewhere. I was doing my work. I said, hey, hang around. I think I'll forget what I'm doing. Talk after 10 minutes. Sit down here only. Very elderly person, very highly successful, from a big international concern, CEO, he sat there. After 10 minutes, when I was through, I said, now talk. What is the thing? Swamiji, frightening silence here. How do you sit? Be afraid of the silence. Because the mind is going to die. And therefore, the mind starts projecting something. And the projection by the mind about the future is called as fear. About the past, it is called as memories. Try this. If you have to remember few hundred days before, what was the shirt that you have put on? Oh God, 200 days before means what date comes? Start struggling, prayatna, efforts. After 30 days, at 5 o'clock, where you will be? I don't know yet. Because the moment you go from the past to the past, future, leaving the present, you struggle. If you remain in the be now, this support is the mantra. See, friend. Therefore, this Vidya Sharira Satta Mantra Rahasya. Now, what happens is indicated very exhaustively. Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, Aksharanam Akarosmi. Among the letters, Aksharas, I am Akar. Oh. See? This is how that Om is indicated as spore. O is beginning without efforts. When you throw the air through the vocal cord, the LS sound is A. Then that sound goes defying by the movement of the tongue. It is called as U. Like we can say, nothing inside the mouth moves. Nothing moves. If you have to say anything else, don't move, don't make your mouth like a chambu and try to say oo. You can't. So, a modified is oo, and the modification culminates in. And how it culminates? A is at the base, throat, no efforts. U is all the modifications. And Ma is the last consonant by the lips. It is called a labial. Oshtya. Pa, pa, ba, ma. Now try to say Ma keeping the lips apart. No. You can't say. So what is the total language? In any way you take it, the total language is starting from A, ending in Ma. Therefore, Om represents the total world. See? And this Om is staying in you, not somewhere else. See, friends? So, this A, when it starts body, it becomes first the Swaramala, A-A-I-E-U-U-A-A-I-O-O-R-R-R-L-L-U-A-M-A-H-A. These are all modifications of A. They are swara, the vowels. Then there are the word consonants which require the throat. They are called as kanthya. K, kh, gha. Then the tongue. Cha, cha, ja, ja, na. Then tha, da, dha, da, talavya. Then dantya. Ta, tha, da, na. When the tongue will touch the teeth, then only you can say. Those old people who have teeth, if they have to ask, tabla bajao. They can't say ta. There was one Sardarji, when the flight approached Bombay, he got up and the announcement was, no, sit down till he got up and started shouting, Bombay aa gaya, Bombay aa gaya. So the air hostess said, be silent. Okay, Bombay aa gaya, Bombay. Because be silent. Experience of yours is God realization. This time, you are nobody. Those who laughed, those who did not laugh, they were somebody. What is there to laugh in a joke? We should suffer. See, friends, relax, relax. You are not going to get anything on the spiritual path. Are you ready for this? Our funny approach is, itna Bhagwan ka kiya, kya mila? See? The whole Bhagavad Gita was told Arjuna, as a result of this Bhagavad Gita, has the situation of changed? It remained the same. Then what happened? I became capable of facing the challenge. Spirituality doesn't mean the things will change around you. We have to change. Our complaint is like an NRI driving car in India. So these people are, you know, okay, see, buffalo has come. They become so excited. But buffalo is not excited. It's cool. See? Now who has got the driving license? You are the one. You should negotiate through properly rather than complaining. If we are in the spiritual path, we have to become more competent. That is the meaning of spirituality. And this can happen only when we start working on the mind. So, when you just study, we come to know the whole world is staying in the mind. Therefore, all the spiritual practice is working on the mind. Whatever path you take, figure ki jitni hai, utni mind ki honi chahiye. See, what efforts we have ever put in our life, take care of our mind. For us, because there are thoughts in the mind, thinkers. No. Because lot of money, that doesn't mean you are rich. You are conjuice. Unless you use that money for some better cause. In the same manner, there are many thoughts in the mind, doesn't mean we are thinker. We are depressed. See, friends, one of my friends outside India, he was also a psychiatrist also. He retired. And Amma took me and we went for some shopping. She wanted to buy some vegetables and all that. And when we came home, I asked her separately. I said, Papa, is your wife depressed? Swamiji, she is a psychiatrist. I said, that makes a very potent candidature. How do you say that she is depressed? You know, the way she is purchasing the things. When a person is depressed, he likes to eat a lot. He likes to accumulate things. He likes to take too much of care on the body all the time. They obsess by something, safi, clean, every time washing the hand. These are all the signs of depression. He who is not depressed, relax. Kya farak padta hai, relax. So wise man is also withdrawn from the world and a depressed person is also withdrawn from the world. Withdrawal through frustration is depression. Withdrawal through wisdom is a dispassion. Because now this Ma has recognized Vidya Sharira Satta Mantra Rahasya. So such a person, he is able to cover. Om. Try when you are at home in your chant Om, but don't make O long. Make Ma long. Many times they make O long. Oh, like a dog barking. Oh, no. Because we are making O out, all the sound waves go outside and disturbance to the. On the contrary, make Ma long. Then all the sound waves influencing each and every cell of your body, and then you slowly cool down. Om. do it few times. Like when you move iron box on the cloth, if it is a cotton, then we sprinkle little water to make it soft. Like that, this long Omkar in Panchadashi it is said, Dirgham Pranavam Uchcharya Manorajyam Viliyate. You know, in the old age, the problems are not about desires. The problems are Manorajya means habitual thinking. No reason we keep on thinking. There is no worry, there is no nothing, there is nothing. One old asked me when I was young. He asked me, Swamiji, don't laugh at me, there is no need, bolo. He said, you know, please don't laugh. I said, I will not laugh, tell me. He was 80 not out. He says, Swamiji, few days, I am remembering, there was one girl in our class, class 1, we were in Jumritalaya. And I don't know, I am remembering she must be now. I said, Budhao, mar gayi. Now, he has no problem. Okay, children are, everything is fine. But this one girl coming from somewhere and I don't know what to do. I said, Google. See, for all the problem, there is only one man in the world today and his name is Swami Googlananda. Anything. One person had a t-shirt, on his t-shirt it was written, I don't Google, my wife knows everything. This experience is called living in. Don't become serious unnecessarily. On God realization, kya karoge baad mein? See? See, you must have seen, there are many people, Bhagwan amuk, tamuk, tamuk. They live with that Bhagwan, not for a day or two, but for years together. And you see the way of their life, useless. There was one beggar, he went to, a mosque. And sitting outside with a ball. All the people came from their prayers, nobody in one paisa there. He got disgusted. Then he went to a church. He sat outside with his ball, nobody gave anything. Then he went to a temple. He sat out there also, nobody gave anything. He got disgusted. He went to a pub. Sitting outside a drinking, place. And within half an hour, his ball was packed with money. He said, oh God, why did you give a wrong address? What will you do with the God's darshan? See, friends, let him express through you. See. That is what is called as Dhitra Rahasya. Otherwise you only get, only lost only in that. And the mantra is as if it is a punishment. Like the children are given punishment, punishment. Guru do mantra 36 times. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. It's not the way. Like the ice cube dissolves in the water, in manner, this mantra dissolves the mind in pure consciousness. Be attentive. Thereafter, it is the consciousness which is expressing through the mind. It is the consciousness which is expressing through the sense organs. It is the consciousness expressing through the body. Presently, we are as the body, for the body, on everybody. Presently, we are living as the sense organs and the whole life is spent in fulfilling the itching of the sense organs. being as the mind and try to live under the emotional onslaught. What is required is we have to live as consciousness through the body, consciousness through the sense organs, as consciousness through the mind. This is the mantra. See. Now, be attentive. What is the meaning of this statement? When the eyes are seeing, let us say you are about two of them, suppose there are another 5,000 added here. Will it make any burden to this? Or all of you go away? Will it be any loss to my eyes? Because vision is independent of the objects. Similarly, when the eyes are closed, is there any loss to the mind? No. Similarly, when the mind dissolves in the consciousness, nothing is lost. That conscious reality is the meaning of mantra rahasya. Otherwise, we keep on only getting lost, you know, I said, you know, and then there was a chamar. See, I never expected, but the things happened. And such people clings. A creeper cannot grow in the desert, always depending on some support. See, friends, spiritual sadhana is discovering your self-confidence. Vishwas is Paramatma Vishwas. If we have faith in God, we can never be weaklings. And you will see most of the people who are sold upasakas, doing bhakti, they are constantly doubtful about God's intentions. They don't have confidence in Him. See, friends, therefore, discover this mantra rahasya in this way. So, every word, where from it begins and where ends, we keep on observing this. So first, mechanical sadhana, whatever your guru has given, finish it off. Otherwise, that will create a virus in your head. Suppose you have to do mantra, three mala, finish it. Same way, ram, 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 ram. Over. Anyway, you are doing like this. More than how many times you chant, what is important is how long you are in divine union. And then you start the second, that you find out how much time you have got. You have got, let us say, 10 minutes or 5 minutes. Then only 5 minutes you have to chant the Lord's name. So you get faster. 5 minutes will take 5 minutes. Then casually, comfortably, and Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. And if needed, fix the alarm of 5, lest you may chant more. See, friends, in this manner, train the mind. This is what is called as working on the mind. When we thus start working on the mind, you will see the mind will be an asset, will not be a liability. Today, our mind is ready for us. If we suffer in life, never because of others, we suffer because of our own mind. And therefore, what do we go one place to another place, one person to another person, but wherever you go, they are the source of all the problems. See, like many people ask this question to us, how many you move to sources, which is the place you like the best? So wherever I am at it, oh, this is the best place I like. Because wherever you are, that matters, isn't it? Where you are not, how does it matter? Therefore, more than where you are, what is important is wherever you are, how you are. See? try one inquiry, like normally we ask the people, hey, how are you? Instead of that, ask this question, hey, did you smile today? How many times you smiled? Koi zarurat nahi smile karne ki. Frustrated people cannot smile. Okay, now, Ishantu evam vidham mantravirya prokarada anusandhana opayikam api parameshwarechad eva navmi bhavati. See how beautiful it is written. Although the truth that one is able to discover this objectless, effortless bliss, yet the teacher says, by the grace of the God, be attentive. If we are the devotee of the Lord, everything happens in our life as God's grace. Upanishad says, Gita says, Audhuna, Ishvara anugrahateva pumsam advaita vasana mahadbhaya paritan vipranam upajayate. If we have an inkling, liking for the truth, understand, it is not our efforts. It is Ishwaranugraha by the grace of God. Many people have got this funny notion. They, particularly the devotees, they say, Swamiji, punya karma have comes surface and therefore we are meeting you. No. See, the result of karma is only two ways. The result of papa is miseries. Result of punya is happiness. What we get in our life is purushartha. See, friends, therefore, if we are walking spiritual path, understand God's grace. And if some obstacles are in our life, understand God's super grace. That is the blessing in disguise. See, take an example for this. Bhagavishna has no business to take the chariot in Dronacharya Bhishmacharya. Had he taken the chariot in front of Duryodhana Dushyasana, there was no need of Bhagavad Gita. Ready to fight with them. But what Bhagavan did? Of all the people on the bed, he took the chariot in front of Bhishmacharya, Dronacharya. And then Arjuna was confused. And when he was confused, Bhagavan was happy. Prabharata, maja a gaya. Don't you? See, there was one small girl. Now she is an officer and very intelligent girl. When she was not even born, since their parents. So, when she was small, she used to call me my Swami. If any other child comes to me, he used to go and hit that child. Go away, don't go to my Swami. He's my Swami, like that. To play fool with her. I said, look here, you have got two of them, mom and dad. I don't want, you know. So, give me dad, you keep mom. Okay, we'll share. No, with her small palm, like a frog's head, she will cover her huge father. No. I said, okay, keep dad, give me mom, she will cook for me. No. And then the mom will say, okay, you be with the dad and I'm Swamiji, you know, because you are troubling me and I'm going with Swamiji. And she will start crying, oh, miserable. And when this was happening to her, do you think we were suffering? Exactly the same way. Bhagwan never suffers in this. He gives a chabi and enjoys. Majarana. Don't take life too seriously. Every event of our life is specially designed for us. See? It is, you know, like the designer's piece. Each one is a designer's piece. Therefore, here the teacher, those who are thus walking the spiritual path, some of them get derailed. and the derailment is they are lost in their various powers and potentialities that they develop. Ishvare chat na hrudayangami bhavati apitu anushangika mat bindunada adi kala janitasu mitasiddhishu chittam rohati. But then, because they have now merged in the consciousness, from there they collect lot and lot of siddhis, and then they are overpowered by the siddhis. Be attentive. Like outer world, comforts, facilities are the obstacles, security are the obstacles on the spiritual path. In the same manner, the inner world, thus obstacles on the spiritual path is all siddhis. You tell somebody, tumhara kaam ho jayega, and the work is, and then this Babaji starts feeling, oh ho, I am a great siddha. Then a shop opens. See, friends, people get lost in that. It is something like, you know, here, you know, in which year, 2000 or 1 or sometime, you know, when there was a lot of this software industry going tremendously high, so only and wife, youngsters, not even in their late 20s, they got millions of dollars, and therefore they will have a huge mansion made to their own, because money, where it will go? And after it is done, then there was a big, you know, fall. And the question comes, nobody ready to buy that house. So when they have big house, they have to show the public. Then to show to the public, they have to have the party. To have the party, they have to cook. What? I have got such a big house, but there is nobody to live here. When the worldly achievements become an atom of exhibition to the world, do you think inner siddhis we will keep quiet? See, there was a friend of mine, Sindhi friend. This happened somewhere in Shimla. I went to their house. Evening time, only two of them were there, oldies. So that Amma was cooking. She says, Swamiji, it will take 10-15. I said, no problem, I'll read you, sir. So the husband said, no, Swamiji, I'll get harmonium. I said, look here, I'm not, hame to lutaliya. I said, I'm not interested in that. Forget the word harmony. Live in harmony rather than harmonium. I said, I don't want, I'll read newspaper. No, you don't sing, I will sing. My God. You can imagine a Sindhi and singing. Any Sindhi, a singer. Except C.H. Atma. C.H. Atma was a Sindhi. Soja Rajakumari. So, he got harmonium, kept in table. He said, Swamiji, I have recently started learning. I can play sarega, sing also. And he opened that and started. No sound coming. He asked wife, hey, what happened? He said, I don't know that dabba, you do whatever you like. I was so frustrated. I said, Mahatmaji, you have not pulled the keys. Oh, I forgot. In export so much, they came in their hand. Now, small little thing, I have learned this music, want to exhibit it, is it not? Arangetram is nothing but that. See, what is this, Bharatanatyam? Simple things made, it is Bharatanatyam. We do car. This is koi jarurat. But when you have learned Bharatanatyam, you have to show to the public. One moment you are I have suffered it lot of times. And then they call, Swamiji, Bharatanatyam, you please come. I said, oh God. Then I say, I wish I could come. I got some stomach problem, you know. these worldly achievements we want to exhibit. Such a person, he ever think about God? See, there was one Bai. She used to compose and sing for the Lord. How many of us? Otherwise, take the jalotas and then Kabi. People are tired. They tack, tack, tack. Kabir and Odi. Are, why you make it so long? Because I want to show exactly the same way. With the worldly things we want to exhibit to the world, these inner siddhis we can keep quiet. And these are the biggest obstacles on the spiritual path. Such people who fall on this, what happens is garbhe chitta vikasaha avishishta vidya sapnaha. So garbhe, in the womb of all these mystic powers, chitta vikasaha, the mind finds fulfillment. So many people are coming to me. How many people come for your lecture? 7-8. 7-8. For my lecture, there are 7 million people coming. Oh. More the dispassion, more the number. More the is more the number of people attending. See, friends, all the definitions have changed. Because chitta vikasa means the mind feels extremely comfortable, fulfilled. You will see, this happens in the lives of those who have always lived only on the stage life. They cannot live a normal life. They want all the time on the stage so that people are watching them. That's it. See, you must have seen, also known, there are many good actors. They died in a most pathetic manner. When they are on the stage, they are in the glory. And their glory is borrowed from the audience. See. Therefore, garbhe chitta vikasaha, in these mystic powers, they become extremely satisfied. And then such people will be always talking about, see, we have to think about body, mind and soul. So first of all, we should make the body a hell. Then mind as calm, then we can make a soul curry in Goa. In Goa, they make a soul curry, you know. It's very tasty, spiritual. See, friends, this body, mind, soul, don't get lost in this. These are just instruments. We are neither against nor for. Like we keep for what? For milk. Then the cow dung comes free. You don't have to do anything for that, you know. Has anybody kept the cow dung for the cow dung? No, hamari dadi chahti hai roz cow dung. Hamne kahe rakh di? No. See? Once I was going somewhere in a, and there was one old amma sitting. Therefore, I never like anybody to go with me. They eat head, you know. So, she had to stop the car somewhere on the way for some reason. And, sir, of the tire or something like that. So, I got down and there was one cattle farm. So, I went, thik karo. Ghum ke aate. So I went for a walk. That old lady, oh, going there. Wait, 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 wait. So I had to wait. Nice, full bisle, she emptied it. Without drinking, 12 rupees. And she, what for? Swamiji, I was thinking of collecting the Gomutra. God, the whole journey will have the fragrance of Gomutra or what? Now how to stop that lady? First of all, old. Secondly, impossible. It is such a dangerous combination. You know? Then I said, you know, I'll tell you, Mama, these are English cows. Then English cows don't give gomutra, they give urine. Do you want urine? No, 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 no. Very good. See? As we keep the cow for the milk, not for dung or the urine, in the same manner, spiritual practice not meant for getting lost in this world. Don't care about the world. Nisargadatta Maharaj used to say very simple words. He used to say, all those who have come to save this world, the saviors of the world, they were shaved off. Where is your Rama? Is Rama? Where is your Krishna, who could not protect his own Dwarka? And his Babaji's, we have come for green peace. See? Don't get lost in this world. The only purpose of our life is to abide in the truth and thereafter let heed what is to be done through us. And become capable, then alone he will select us. Therefore, garve chitta vikasaha avishishta vidya sapna, then such a person is living in this world as if he is living in the dream world. And he tries to find fulfillment in that. See? Don't get lost. One of the practices, keep observing the quality of your mind. You should never fist. Don't take things seriously. We are merely expressing the divine principle through the body, the speech, the sense organs and the mind. Discard the object to the mind, to the senses. Discard the sense organs, come to the mind. Discard the thoughts, come to the consciousness. Consciousness you cannot discard. It is said, everybody finds your mistakes, he is your well-wisher. When somebody is going praising you again and again, beware, you are likely to be caught on wrong steps. See? Therefore, Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahansa used to say, never take a position of a guru in life. Remain always a seeker of truth. Otherwise, we get lost. So, garve chitta vikasaha avishishta vidya sapna. Then, they are all the time living in this dream world. And start living in the dream world, they are sometime happy, sometime miserable, sometime successful, not successful. Therefore, protect yourself from yourself is the only spiritual case. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shantanti Shantihi Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.